In this video, I'm going to teach you how you can integrate structured data into one of your WordPress pages. This also shows how the structured data generator is used. Hey and welcome back. Nice to have you in the first lesson of Module 2. In Module 2, we're getting our hands dirty and push some structured data out into this world. I'm happy that you made it till here. I am Florian, the developer of Snip, the rich snippets and structured data plugin for WordPress. If you want to use the plugin, please feel free to follow the link that you can find in the description area. In the last lesson of Module 1, I have taught you how to find the right structured data type and their properties. Let's go through it quickly once again. First, you have to identify what schema type you need to integrate. Let's say you are offering a self-made teacup on one of your landing pages. So you know you want to add schema type for a cup, if that exists. Now you go to schema.org to see if there is a schema type for teacups. You search under the creative work because you think it's something creative you've made. But as you find out, there is nothing that would fit exactly. So what to do now? Of course, you could use creative work here because your handmade teacup is exactly that. And because there is no teacup schema, you need to use the next type that fits, and that is creative work. From the other lessons, you know that creative work does not create a rich snippet in search results. But you want to stand out. You want to get this product picture into your search results. Just like you saw it in the very first lesson of Module 1, because that is what's more visually attractive to the user. So because the product schema fits best here, you have decided to stick with it. Now you have to go to Google's reference to see how a product type should look like in order to get a rich snippet in search results. From the previous lesson, you know that you can find the reference here. If you are on the podcast right now, you will find all the links in the description area. So feel free to stop here and take a look at Google's reference for the product type. Now, carefully read through the description and the guidelines. It will help you understand what you can and what you cannot do. If done, scroll down to the property list of the product. You will find a list of properties that are required and some that are just recommended. So now you know that you want to use the product schema type and you know what properties to use. Now let's add them to your landing page using Snip, my rich snippets and structured data plugin for WordPress. By the way, you can also use the structured data generator that you can use for free on richsnippets.io. This is a reduced version of the generator that I have built into my plugin. In the end, you will get a ready-to-use JSON-LD code snippet. There is one more clarification that I have to make. In the plugin, I often use the word snippet. By that, I mean a code snippet that will be generated out of the syntax that you are generating with the generator. Don't be confused, because a single search result is also called snippet. I assume you have installed and activated the plugin already. Just make sure that the post type page is selected on the settings page of the plugin, because we are now adding a snippet to a page. Don't worry about my German pages that I have created here. Only the page Extraordinary Japanese Teacup is interesting at this point. As you can see, I'm using Gutenberg, the new editor that ships with WordPress 5.0. At the time of the creation of this video, WordPress 5.0 was not officially released. So you can get a free, nice sneak peek in this video as well. Don't worry about the editor itself. The creation of the snippet is the same with the old editor that will work until the end of the year 2023, I guess. We scroll down to Rich Snippets area and click on the Add a Rich Snippet button. As you know from the previous videos, schema.org is hierarchical. That means everything is a thing in the first place. You can search for a specific thing using the text field here. For example, if you want to add the creative work, or you can just hit any of these buttons to create a schema type. For us, it would be the product type. As you can see, some of the properties are loaded already. These are the recommended properties that you saw on Google's reference page. A click on the link here would bring you to the schema.org product page, where you can see all the properties that are possible at the moment. Back to the property list. You can always delete a property if you think you don't need it by using the link delete. Or you can always add more properties by just searching for them. For example, if I enter the word color, the plugin would offer the color property to me. A click would add it to the list. By clicking the edit link, you can add a value to the property. The description shows what you can or should enter here. In this case, the stock keeping unit. For me, it would be just cups. Because I want to enter my own text here, I choose direct text input and enter the word cups. Again, remember Google's reference page for the product. Because Google is on top of schema.org, it may be that a different value is expected than the one suggested by schema.org. As you can see here, SKU just needs to be plain text. While we are here, let's take a look at the required properties again. We just scroll up and here they are. In this case, just image and name is required. The other properties down below are just recommended properties. We will see later that Google Structured Data Test Tool gives you a big fat error message when a required property is missing. If a recommended property is missing, it will show you a warning instead. To keep this video short and to provoke some error messages later, I will delete all properties for now except the name and the offers. For the name, I will enter the name of my teacup. Because the name is the same as the page title, I can just choose page title here. When you are on the free structured data generator on my website, you will not have this option. From the previous lessons, you know that the offers property expects a schema type named offer. Google's reference list tells you the same when you scroll up to the offer. Plus, in the subschema, there are also recommended and required properties. When we edit the offers property now, the plugin offers you the related types already. We choose offer. This will load the subschema with the recommended properties. For now, let's stick with three required properties. I have pre-filled them quickly. Let's go through it. I think it's clear what the price is. The description tells you that you should not include a currency code because that's a different property. We will see that in a minute. Also note that the usage of a dot indicates a decimal point. So for all European countries, please do not use the comma here. As we scroll up, you will see the already mentioned currency code. In this example, it's just euros. Last but not least, there is the availability of the item. This is a special property because it expects a descendant schema type. Luckily, the plugin covers this as well. So all you need to do is to select the right descendant. In my case, it's just the in stock type to show search engines that it's available for shipping. Very cool. We have created our first snippet. Let's save this post and check the output with Google's Structured Data Test Tool. As I have mentioned in one of the last lessons, you can just enter an URL into the tool and it will analyze and validate what you have built. Here we have our product snippet, and as you can see, it complains about the image property that is currently missing. In this case, we would need to add this property and fill it with the right values. I would also recommend to add the recommended properties, not only the required ones. P Please note that, like every other Google product, it's permanently changing. So sometimes it complains about required or recommended properties, and sometimes, as you can see here, it does not. Sometimes you get error messages where there are no errors at all. It's weird. In this case, I would trust the Search Console a little more, and this is what I'm going to show you next. But before that, please note that the plugin internally has its own cache mechanism. For performance reasons, the created snippets are cached. If you still get any errors in Google Structured Data Tool, even though you changed something, please make sure that the cache is cleared, both from Snip plugin and from any cache plugin you use. You can find the Clear Cache button here on the Settings page. When you scroll down, Clear Cache. So don't forget that. So let's jump over to the tool that I've mentioned. This is the URL where you can find the Google Search Console. If you are on the podcast right now, as always, please go to the description area where you can find the link. You can stop and pause here and have a look at the Search Console as well. In Google Search Console, there is a menu called Structured Data that you can find under the Search Appearance. If you can't see it, you are maybe on the new Search Console that looks like this. Google currently works on a new Search Console that looks more pretty. At the time this video was made, there was no Structured Data menu in the new Search Console. So if you are using the new Search Console, you should switch back to the old one using the menu item that says go to the old version. So let's have a look at the structured data analysis in the Search Console. It mainly helps you identify errors on structured data. As you can see, the current page had a lot of errors 2 months ago. They were fixed, sorted out, and are now valid. Because this site is a job posting site, the number of schemas are increasing with every new job post, because the job posting schema together with the organization schema is used very heavily on this site. So the primary use case is to find errors. If there are errors, the analysis tool will tell you exactly on what page the error occurred and what the error is. So in this case, the author property is missing. If you click on the error, Google shows more detailed information about what it has gathered from this page when it was crawled, how the schema type looks like, and so on. A click on the button Test Live Data brings you back to Google Structured Data Test Tool. Now let's repeat. In this video, you have learned, like in the lesson before, how you can find the right schema type. I have showed how you can generate structured data within Snip, the rich snippets and structured data plugin for WordPress. I have mentioned that you can also use the structured data generator free of charge on richsnippets.io. However, as you saw in the videos, it has some limitations that the original version doesn't have. We used Google Structured Data Test Tool to validate the snippets. And I have quickly mentioned the structured data menu in Google's Search Console. Very well done! In the next video, I'm going to show you how global snippets work and how it makes your life a whole lot easier. See you there!